morning at Walmart and a bakery. It is fucking windy today. Windy up this mountain, but we found this elusive campsite where people said they had built wind protection. It was hard to find, but we found it, so we're gonna camp here tonight. We're literally in the middle of a wind farm, but thank gosh some people built this tent site. Okay. Climbed up a little bit of Tehachapi, not as many miles as I would have liked. I really wanted to get a little bit further today, but also like there's no rush. We're in good timing for Kennedy Meadows. We pushed so much to like meet Zoe and Liam in time that like we don't really need to do huge days now, and especially just trying to relax our bodies before going into the Sierras. But also we spent so long at Walmart today that like like ended up leaving way later than I thought. I think we didn't hit the trail until like 12:31. So we did 12 miles. And that was good. A lot of them were uphill, so I think that was a good first day. Super windy. Never been so scared of wind in my life. We were in like one of the windiest places in the country, I think. As you could see yesterday, and like if I was to flip you around right now. Wind farms, like this wind farm is huge. Apparently Gavin's reading this wind farm produces more energy than all the wind farms combined in France, just because it's so big. And it's so windy. And today was like the first day I've actually ever been scared of wind. Like I was just, there's so, wind is like 60 miles an hour today, and we're in a wind farm. So it was a big wind day, and we're in a wind farm, and we're climbing up in altitude. So I was just like on an open corner of the mountain doing a turn for one of the switchbacks, and I literally just almost fell off the mountain. We resupplied so much food. My pack is the heaviest it's ever been. I was carrying 5 liters of water plus 2 full Gatorades, which probably is another liter. And then also 6 days of food. I usually carry breakfast and snacks. Gab usually carries lunch and dinner. It's about even, they both fit into like one food pack, but today we overflowed the food pack. So I had my full food pack plus another bag. So it was just really heavy and I was not used to the weight and I was really gonna fall over. So it was really scary. I've never been scared of the wind before, but we live to see everything. So excited to crawl into the tent tonight, have an early night, and hopefully the winds are going to calm by tomorrow and we can finish doing the ascent of Tehachapi. Cheryl, our trail angel last night, told us that Tehachapi means in Native American hard climb up, but like I don't know if she was joking or if that's true. Today it seems like it was true. I don't know. I'm going to research it and put it in the link or something. Slept through my alarm this morning because it was a very windy night, so having breakfast in the sleeping bag. Not a bad view either. Just windy. Last night, but we camped not too far up because it was so windy and so terrible. And then today we wanted to try, and then try to push to Kennedy Meadows, I think, deciding that it wasn't that much farther than Ridgecrest. So trying to do about 23 miles a day, 23 and a half. So today has felt long. We were like before we met Zoe and Liam, we were doing those 26, 28 mile days. But then we took like a zero, two half zeros, really close together to Tehachapi and a hiker town. It was just so nice to not be walking all day and to get back into the swing of things. Also, packs. Water. There's like crazy water carries. The last water carry was 20 miles. This is like 20 as well, or 19. And so just full up with water, full up with food, walking uphill in windstorms. Not the like most fun part of trail, but knowing that we're gonna maybe get to Kennedy Meadows on the earlier side so we can relax and, you know, not rush ourselves and hear us is also really good. So we'll see what happens. We're here here's our campsite for tonight. We did 22 point something miles, so we're on track to get to Kennedy Meadows. We're supposed to do 22 each day. You can see in the distance the wind turbine, but just trying to make sure it's not super windy. And that we have a good night. Okay, tonight what's on the menu? Angel hair. So we get angel hair because it's the quickest to cook. So thin, it only takes 4 or 5 minutes. So, it's not really that boiling though. Anyways, it only takes 4 or 5 minutes, so it's able to cook quicker than anything other than like gnocchi, but gnocchi is really heavy for how much it would feed. So we've chosen angel hair and it does the job. The only problem is that, I don't know, like in Brazil and stuff, we found like sauce in a plastic thing, which is just much more light. In the States, they only have glass, which I mean, normally I'd be so for, because it's way more environmentally friendly. But there's just, you can't find any plastic sauce in a can. I keep saying to Gab, we should just put it in a Ziploc, like a double Ziploc, and get a good sauce, like a vodka sauce or something, because they're so cheap. He doesn't think the Ziploc will hold, so there's an ongoing debate about that. So we keep getting these cheap, weird sauces in the tin cans. Oh shit, I was supposed to start the timer, hold on. In the end, we put some butter and some meat crumbles, these things in there to make it more like a bolognese. So, finished product. Woke up early this morning. I have a bunch more miles to do. I wanted to keep sleeping because this tent site is so peaceful, but I'm gonna have to get going. Red lights of turbines in the distance. Not a bad view.
Yeah.
Part of a spine of something on the side of the way. Ew. Ew, 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 babe, ew. It's gross. I don't know what did that. There's no meat left on it. Here's Gab trying a new trick we learned from our new friends up here. Three hikers we were hiking with today: Zebediah, the butcher, and Lost and Found. And Lost and Found had this trick of putting the sticks underneath the tent line so that you get more headroom, and boy does it work. So today was a big day. We didn't actually hike that many miles, but I don't know, I just had like an emotional spurt today. I like I'm just getting kind of nervous about the Sierras. I'm really slow uphill. Sorry, this is crazy. I'm really slow uphill with my knees and just with my big pack, and it's making me a little bit insecure because people will pass me. And I feel like a little bit nervous about like doing like 700 miles of just uphill, because it's the part I hate the most about this hike. I just feel very uncomfortable with my knees, and I don't know, going uphills and I go downhill and my knees just like are not working like that well. So I think I just reached a level where I was trying to walk up the hill and like I was just getting frustrated and started feeling really like the fourth person had passed us, and I was just feeling like really helpless and like vulnerable. I don't know, so I started crying because I was just frustrated with myself and I was worried about the Sierras. And then I don't know, I just started crying. I just had like a wave of like, I don't know, like loss, or I don't know. I like went through losing a friend this year, for those of you who don't know me, and the grief like comes and goes, and I just felt like, I don't know, I think I was triggered because it was a very sudden death, and like I found out in a very like quick way. It's just like a message about it, and like the physicality of that moment is like feeling helpless and vulnerable and just like weak. And I think when I physically was like going through a situation that was making me feel that physically again, like I don't know, I just like was triggering to me. And I think I've just been thinking a lot about her on this walk because you know, she died at 31, and I'm here doing something so like adventurous and carnal and like human, and it just makes me think that she won't get to experience anything like that anymore. And it's just, today was a crazy day. I don't know, I know that grief comes in waves, and I've been dealing with it since she passed. In some ways this has been like a really great year because we got married, so many things, 2021, sorry, I'm speaking about the full calendar here, but in other ways, like going through this loss has been really hard and it's hit me in waves. So today was an amazing day. It wasn't great, but then we had lunch and we met up with these other hikers who are really nice and started making me just like laugh and just like distract myself from that, and that was really cool. And then we kind of spent all day, and we were gonna push on to try and make it to like Kennedy Meadows by a certain time, but like we stuck with them tonight just to hang out and chill. And I think it was a good call because I think I'm pushing myself to like get through this by a certain date, and like we have these timelines and constrictions, and I feel like I'm just putting a lot of pressure on myself to like do everything the best when I can like take it slow and do things on my own and in my own way. There's Gab in the background saying goodnight. But yeah, it was good. I think it was a good day. And I think like a lot of people go on this walk for different reasons. Some dealing with loss, some dealing with like addiction or like whatever. And this is by no means why I came on this walk. This walk was planned way before even her passing, but I think it has been like a good place for me to like really reflect on things and get some stuff out and kind of have like cathartic times. And I was like, you know what? I promised you I would take you with ever, like I promised her I would take her wherever I went, and like she's seen a lot of places in the past few weeks. I've taken her a lot of places, and so today when I like signed the trail register, I also signed her name, which I thought was nice. And just like taking time to remember her out here has been nice. So yeah, good and bad, lots of things coming up, lots of people told me that things would come up, and yeah, I was kind of like shocked, and maybe my body like physically sensed like the metaphor of like an uphill battle with grief and an uphill like physically today, I don't know, but I was triggered in some way, and it was weird because I was crying for like, I don't know why, but I hope it was needed. Anyways, that's my rant for today, my sign off. And yeah, lots of tears, lots of laughs, lots of everything out here. I think it's been good in that way. It's been cool. We should do like a before and after. Yeah. Thank you.
fall. So be the girl you loved. Be the girl you loved. Always. So show me why you're strong. Ignore everybody else. We're alone now. Always. So show me why you're strong. Ignore everybody else. We're alone now. Suddenly I'm hidden. It's the darkness of the dawn. And your friends are gone. And your friends won't come. So show me where you fit. So show me where you fit. So show me why you're strong. Ignore everybody else. We're alone now.
Of water. For those of you who are hiking the PCT, usually a water cache is like, I don't know, 10 or 15 like little, not little bottles, but gallon bottles from a grocery store that Trail Angels put out. So they're not super reliable. So Gab and I don't usually count those as a water source usually because we just aren't sure if there's going to be any left when we get there. But this one, on the trail. Yesterday was a long day. Gab and I did over 27 miles. We did 27 miles of trail and then also at one point got lost. And maybe did an hour off trail back and forth. So that was fun. Very windy last night. Very excited about our decision to go into town. Hi guys. So last night I recorded a video, but it may or may not be in this because it might have been too dark. It was really dark. Oh god, I look so tired. Did not sleep well last night. As you can hear, probably still very windy where we are. We're doing our last miles to, trail's going all well. We're doing our last miles to Walker Pass. Like I said, we were going to push to go to Kennedy Meadows just because I'm so competitive and I'm like, I want to be the first one from our date there. I want to pass all these people. I love everyone I'm hiking with, but I'm also super competitive with everyone. I'm like, oh, I want to be in really good timing. I want to have made it to Kennedy Meadows in, you know, like less than 40 days, like all this shit. But then I also see people around me who are hiking and like taking zeros in cool towns and like going to Magic Mountain and doing all this stuff, and I'm like, I also want that. I don't want to blink and have had this experience pass and like have rushed it because I was being competitive. So Gab and I are gonna take a much needed zero. Even have two nights at the hotel so we can literally just stay in bed all day and chill. I'm gonna edit some videos for you guys. We're gonna have a good meal. I might go see Batman in town, dynasty movie, sleep in two bed. I mean, sleep in a bed for two nights before going into the fucking snow for how many days, and also not having internet connection or anything. So very excited on this plan to Ridgecrest. We hiked 27 miles yesterday, so we would have a short morning so we could hitch in today. So only 12 or 13 miles this morning, which feels like a fucking blessing. And yeah, so just doing our last mile and a half to Walker Pass. It's a really pretty piece of section here. Got the mountains in the distance. We will have reached Walker Pass on our 36th day of trail, which is good. If we kept going, we could definitely have made it to Kennedy Meadows within 40 days. Even with our break, we might still make it there within 40 days or 41 days, which is pretty good timing. 40 days, 700 miles. It's going to be, that's pretty good. We did a good pace. So very excited to be trying to hitchhike to Ridgecrest. There's a movie theater, as I said. There's like lots of restaurants, multiple hotels. Super pumped. And yeah, just excited for some town break, some internet, some fried food, maybe some alcohol. Who knows? Gonna get crazy. Right, Gab? Crazy.
What?
We're gonna get crazy.
Oh, yeah.
Town day.
Yesterday we did 42 kilometers.
42 kilometers is the translation in kilometers for those of you. We also hit the 600 mile marker and the 1,000 kilometer mile marker, or 1,000 kilometer marker, which was fun. So, yeah, another beautiful day in California, and life seems pretty sweet. We see that little bit of road in the distance as we're walking down Gap's, and it's like Friday afternoon at work. You know, the weekend's coming and it's the best time, because when you're on the weekend or when you're in town, you know, there's not that much time left. It's the anticipation that's the best. And seeing this road with a lot of cars means maybe there's lots of people willing to pick us up for a hitch. It's gonna be pretty sweet. So we just got a hitch with a guy who's really nice. He picked us up. We were by the campground, and all the other hikers went up to go to like by the bus. And I said, Gab, like, let's not hitchhike there because everyone will be there. So we hitchhiked like early on the road in the direction we were going. And obviously we got the hitch, and we drove past all the other hikers looking angry and annoyed, but every man for himself. But he was working, so he was not able to drive us all the way to where we're going. So he just dropped us at the highway, but we're really close to where we're going, so we just have to get one more lucky hitch, and that's it. Okay, so we're trying to get the second leg of our hitchhike into Ridgecrest, and we put our thumbs out, and this guy pulls over, and we start running towards the car, and he's like, no, I don't actually have any room, but this is for you. And he gave us this book, and we're like, what? And then he comes back a few minutes later, and he signs it, and we're like, okay. And then the dedication is, this book is dedicated to all of those who continue to pick up hitchhikers. So it's obviously something to do with hitchhiking, but he didn't actually give us a ride. He claimed he had no room, despite having a big Jeep. But he said he drove all the way from Costa Rica, so maybe he had a bunch of shit in there. I'm excited to read there and figure out what this book is. Back in another Walmart. the guy who hitchhiked from dropped us off at Walmart because he thought we had to resupply. And
what fresh hell
is this? Why is there so much good stuff that we don't get in Canada? Probably because it's poison. But that looks great. Just like the Funfetti pancake mix that I just saw. What fresh hell is all of this? Lucky Charms pancakes? Like, why wasn't this around when I was growing up? Never would have been allowed to eat it because my mom thought Honey Nut Cheerios were a treat, but it would have been cool to eat at friends' houses. With our Walmart haul, checking in to the good old Motel 6. Yeah, I've always wanted to stay at Motel 6. Iconic, clearly. Oh god. It is really hot here. It's not like before, it's hot. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Super sweet. This is pretty sweet. Going to do our laundry. It's only like 2 minutes from Motel 6, it's the largest hotel that has helped us with our laundry, slash had a laundry in it, so it'll be funny. My look is really crazy. Gab's wearing his rain jackets, so he can wash all his tops. Second pair of shorts, I'm wearing my second pair of shorts and a shirt that I think I'm going to send home now that we're getting to the Sierras because I'm not wearing it much. Extra weight. It was my sun shirt that's supposed to have SPF protection in it. We are in the bustling metropolis of Ridgecrest, which is about 28,000 people. We're going to Toronto, New York, or Paris, or Marseille is in a lot of peeps, but for the freaking PCT, it is like New York, baby. 28,000 peeps, a Carl's Jr., two gas stations, girl. Anyways, that's for the updates. This is our destination, Thrifty Wash Fluff and Fold. Smile, you're also on camera, Thrifty Wash. This vending machine looks a little empty, but it's pretty cool in here. And here is our humble abode. Motel 6. It's honestly not so bad. I look like a crazy person, but we are going to, like, convince Gab to go to, like, the only Thai restaurant that has been within 100 miles of me. It doesn't have a good rating, it's not super close, but I just really want Thai food, and I don't know the next time I'm going to be able to get any sort of Thai food. I literally look crazy. I have no laundry, I have no hair products, I don't fit in a normal society, but I'm gonna go eat some curry, some pad thai, some spring rolls, and live it up. First glass of wine in a while, nice beer, I'm smoking a cigarette. Bangkok House Thai. It seems like it's gonna be good. She's Thai, but old lady, yeah. Cooking, so that's a good time. Thai food, something we've missed so much. Thai is a staple in our lives. Ate a lot of food. from Northeast Thailand. She was really sweet. It was good to have a good meal. So Nav and I went to the Thai feast on the other side of town, and there was one Uber working when we got there, but she said she would stay online for our return, but she didn't. So now we're walking. I'm walking in flip-flops to the other side of town, back to the Motel 6. Got a little tequila paloma from one of the stores I stopped at, and the Walgreens is on the way, which was fun. But yeah, I was in his shorts and hiking shoes. I'm in flip flops and my icebreakers. Don't know about the hitchhiking at night. Unless our friend's still at Home Depot deciding between things.
One, two, three, one.
Right off. This is self-care.
I don't have a brush to apply my mask. I got a little mask.
My good friend Danzy, we call this the Dan bun when it's just a laissez-faire bun on top of her head. Sometimes she wears like a headband like this, so I'm feeling like this little wisp movement. I feel like I'm channeling her right now. Hi Danzy, if you're watching, I know you're watching. Love you! So we are walking now on our zero in Ridgecrest to go to Denny's. Gab's never been to Denny's. 24-hour diners are not a thing in France. I mean, not going to Denny's, not really a big issue. It's pretty gross, but going to 24-hour diner is like the best thing ever. There's not much option anyway here, so we're gonna go to Denny's and have a breakfast, a big old breakfast, and we're gonna eat a bunch today, lunch, dinner, hopefully go to a movie, have the time, super exciting.
Get drunk without her, and I won't do her no.
Pulling up to Denny's.
She's the sweetest blackberry wine.
Gab not knowing to get a Denny's. Want to get a Denny's? It's like overwhelming. Should he get the endless breakfast? Should he get the crazy pancakes?
This
all the people.
How we sound like Germans.